Hello everyone. In this video lecture, let us discuss about sp2 hybridization. sp2 hybridization. In sp2 hybridization, one s orbital mixes with two p orbitals to form three hybrid orbitals. Let me show you them. This is s orbital. It mixes with two p orbitals. Let me take px and py. This is py. These three will intermix and form a trigonal shape like this, and the bond angle is 120 degrees. There are many number of examples for this sp2 hybridization. Let me take two. Example one is BF3 molecule, boron trifluoride molecule, and other C2H4 ethene molecule, etc. Let me explain this BF3 molecule. In BF3 molecule, boron is the central atom. Electronic configuration of boron is 1s2, 2s1, 2px1, 2py1 in its excited state. So, here there are three unshared electrons which are ready to bond with these three fluorine atoms. Let me write the electronic configuration of fluorine also. In fluorine, there is 1s2, 2s2, 2px2, 2py2 and 2pz1. So, this pz orbital is ready to make bonds with these three hybrid orbitals. Let me write its structure. This is boron. These are the three hybrid orbitals which are having one electron each, and this pz orbital comes and make bond with this one like this. There is a sigma bond because of sigma sp2 and pz overlap, and again here also sigma sp2 pz. This is fluorine, this is fluorine, this is boron, and here also there is a sigma bond formed by sp2 and pz overlap. The bond angle here is 120 degrees. Let me write its structure like this. B, F, F, and F. The bond angle is 120 degrees. Let me show the 3D model for this molecule also. Yes, this is the 3D model for this BF3 molecule. Here, this sky blue ball is representing boron atom, and these three are three fluorine atoms. So, you will have a structure like this. This is a trigonal structure where the bond angle is 120 degrees. Is that clear? Let me take other example also. C2H4. In this molecule also, there are two carbon atoms. So, let me write the electronic configuration of those two carbon atoms. So, this is the carbon 1, 1s2, 2s1, 2px1, 2py1 and 2pz1, and there is other carbon atom, again 1s2, 2s1, 2px1, 2py1 and 2pz1. Let us calculate the needed number of electrons to make this molecule. What I mean to say here is, here there is a C2. That means you need two unshared electrons to make a bond between two carbon atoms. And there are four hydrogen atoms. That means you need four more unshared electrons to make a bond. So, total you need six unshared electrons to form this molecule. Keeping this in mind, so let me write like this. It undergoes sp2 hybridization, and this carbon also undergoes sp2 hybridization. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 6 unshared electrons are there. So, you will get the molecule like this. This is the hybrid orbital of first carbon atom. And this is the hybrid orbital of next carbon atom. So, there will be a sigma bond. You have to write like this, sigma sp2-sp2 overlap. There are two more hybrid orbitals for this carbon atom. Let me write them also. And similarly, there are two more hybrid orbitals for this carbon atom also. Each orbital is having one unshared electron ready to make bond with those hydrogen atoms. Now, hydrogen atoms will come and make a bond like this. This is H formed due to sp2-s. Similar type of bonds are formed here also. This is H. This is H. This is H. Each carbon atom is possessing one unhybridized p orbital for to make a pi bond. So, let me show that bond also. This is unhybridized p orbital. And here also it is unhybridized p orbitals. There will be a bond, that is pi bond, between these two pure p orbitals. That bond is represented like this, pi pz-pz. Is that clear? Let me show this molecule like this also. It is similarly represented like this. C, single bond C, this is H and H, this is H, and there is a pi bond. So, here the bond angle HCH is 120 degrees. In this molecule, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 sigma bonds, and there is 1 pi bond. Its shape is trigonal shape, and its bond angle is 120 degrees. Let me show you this molecule also. So, here, this is the molecule. Here, these two black balls are representing two carbon atoms. And these two are representing these two hydrogen atoms. And finally, these two are representing these two hydrogen atoms. And if you see this molecule, there is a double bond. If you closely observe this molecule, these HCH and HCH are in this plane where these two pi bonds are in this plane. These two are in different planes. Suppose if you see like this, I think you can understand it very clearly. These two are two pi bonds and these are HCH bonds. These two are in different planes. The bond angle here is 120 degrees. Is that clear? Okay. I will ask you a simple question. We already discussed about ammonia molecule. If you see that group as amine group at any place, you can't directly say the hybridization without seeing the nature of bonds attached to that amine group. Now let me explain you clearly. Suppose if I take like this a molecule, CH3, single bond CH2, single bond NH2, there is a lone pair. Here in this amine group, the carbon atom attached to that one is having sigma bonds. There is no pi bond. So you can say that this is sp3 hybridized nitrogen. Suppose if you find like this CH2 double bond CH single bond NH2, and if you find a lone pair on this nitrogen atom, now you can't say that it is in sp3 hybridization. Why? Because this lone pair has an ability to make resonance. That means this lone pair will not confinedly fix it to this nitrogen atom only. Here is a possibility. That means this lone pair may come here and this pi bond may come here. That means the position of this lone pair is not fixed here. So in this type of situation, you have to say that this nitrogen is in sp2 hybridization. So the presence of a pi bond influences the molecule. Of course, we will discuss about it in the coming video lectures. I am here just representing that you can't say any hybridization by seeing the atom itself. You have to see the environment around that atom, and then only you have to decide whether it is in sp3 hybridization or sp2 hybridization. Is that clear? And again, here is a question for you. That means you made like this, you left some pure pz orbitals for pi bond. Why can't you take them into the hybridization and make pi bond with those hybrid orbitals only? No, not at all. You cannot make any pi bond with the hybrid orbitals. Why? Because I'll explain you clearly. Please follow. So let us take the formation of sigma and pi bonds. Suppose if I take s orbital like this, it will be represented with a positive sign. And if I take another s orbital, it should also be represented with a positive sign. Where if you mix these two, you will find a sigma bond. It is a constructive mixing. Suppose if I take two p orbitals, those will have plus and minus signs. You can mix these two. That means these two will be mixed and formed a bond like this. Plus will mix with plus and minus will mix with minus. Suppose if I take this S and if I want to make a bond with this one, like this, that means I want to make a bond with these two lobes with this s orbital. It is not possible. Why? Because here if you take this plus and minus, this lobe will not mix with two directly and will not make any bond. If you want to add this s orbital to this p orbital, you have to add like this sigma bond only. This is plus, this is minus. You can add like this. But you cannot add this s orbital directly to two lobes. Is that clear? In all hybridizations, suppose if you have taken this sp3 hybridization or sp2 hybridization, what it is representing? The hybrid orbital contains some s character. Isn't it? Yes, this hybrid orbital is containing some s character, so that they won't participate in pi bond formation because s character was there and you cannot mix two hybrid orbitals to form a pi bond. That's why we are taking two pure p orbitals to make a pi bond. Of course, we will come across this type of concept in linear combination of atomic orbitals, which is the basic for the formation of molecular orbital theory. Let us have an idea here only. That means we have to make pi bond between pure orbitals only. Is that clear? Let us discuss about sp hybridization in the coming video lecture. Thank you.